Hey everyone, it's Evan here from The Trade Risk on Friday, June 7th, here with a weekend market recap video. We're going to cover all of the major markets, the current market environment, and then finish off with some sector analysis. So we're already at the weekend. It was a holiday shortened week. Markets were closed on Tuesday for Independence Day and half day on Monday, but we did have some turbulence today. All in all, a pretty flat, fairly mixed week. Sellers tried to get some of that momentum in their favor. They tried to make progress to the downside, but as we've seen many times this year, they really just couldn't get that follow through, didn't see the big washout, the big pullback, or the big panic sort of move set in. Bulls stepped in and we got that rebound here on Friday, actually, to finish off the week. So let's take a look here at the charts. Let's kick it off with the weekly chart of the S&P 500. We're looking at the cash market still, and you can see here that we've really just gone nowhere for the past 5 weeks, 5.5 weeks or so, moving sideways in this range, spending most of the time between this 2420 and 2442 level. That's only about a 1%, a little over 1% size range that we've been trading in. And you can see with the wicks here down at the bottom, the tails of the last two weekly bars, you can see the sellers have got a little, you know, loud in their movements here, but ultimately we still see dip buyers kind of stepping up here and not letting this market roll over. So if we go down to the daily time frame, that 2420 level, that's this line right here. You can see it's played support going all the way back to the beginning of June, and we did close above it to end the week. We had this violent kind of move lower here on Thursday, where we had a 1% down day closing pretty ugly, but again, it didn't last. We didn't get the follow through. This could have been a situation that the sellers could have taken control, could have started to really roll this market over and start to pull back in a deeper fashion, maybe do some more technical damage, but it didn't happen. So once again, we're back above 2420 inside the sideways range that we've been in. Nothing new as far as where we are trading. So to me, it's more chop ahead. Individual sectors, individual stocks, they're going to move, they're going to outperform, underperform, but the broad market, the market environment as a whole is kind of back in this choppy mess, and you're going to have to look for opportunity in individual sectors or those stocks to really start to outperform here. It's easy to get chopped up, and given the move we saw it towards the end of the week here, up 70 basis points, recovering most of the selling here from Thursday, that's a good start. Bulls held again right where they needed to. Can they follow through? Can they work themselves back up into this range? Can we get follow through next week? That's something I'll be looking for immediately on Monday. And if we do start to roll back over, can we, you know, do we give up 2420? Do we head back to these lows? 2410, is this going to be a reference point? The lows here from last Thursday and the prior Thursday. So something to pay attention to if we start to roll back over. You can see the 8 and 20 period moving average here, very flat right above price. Again, kind of indicative of sort of a headache, choppy environment. So probably, you know, best to maybe take a slight step back, reduce exposure, or at least try not to be as active on these swings, just because it does seem to be like we're heading into kind of that chop box, back in that chop box, or continuing in that chop box into the second week of July. Now, if we go to the NASDAQ 100, we can see here that we did once again hold that support right where we needed to, right around this 136 level, kind of closed here in a very iffy situation, kind of looking over a cliff here with a lot of air underneath this market. If we started to roll over from 136, the lows here from the mid-May, and we did hold. Again, the environment may not look that attractive. Nothing here compels me to start saying everything looks good to start buying dips again here in the queues, just given the bearish alignment here in the 8 and 20 period moving average. You still got kind of this downtrend, this potential lower high here at work. So there are, you know, still very mixed signals here in the NASDAQ. It's constructive that we held these lows. Maybe we can muster up more of a bounce, maybe get back into this old range closer to 140 next week. That would be constructive to see. But for now, I think you still warrants at least a little caution, maybe smaller position size, reduced risk, however you want to approach it. Everybody's coming at this with some different strategies and time frames. So from the swing trader standpoint, still being a little bit cautious here on the queues. There's other sectors that are a little more impressive in my mind. And the IWM, you can see, broke down on Thursday from this trend line that kind of held up supported price for about almost 2 weeks of trading. We came crashing below it on Thursday, again, right into support here, kind of looking over a cliff, no follow through, got the bounce back instead. And you see we finished just at Thursday's highs here, intraday highs anyway. And still just holding this bigger support here. So maybe this, if we zoom out here, you can see we're kind of grinding higher in this slightly tilted higher rising channel. And then you have this sideways range here in between this 139, call it 142 level. Line in the sands here, pretty clear. If we started to lose 139, that'd be certainly a time to reassess risk and tighten up or make some adjustments if the IWM started to lose that. Kind of still looks best in class here, especially this weekly chart, although the weekly chart should get our attention here, just given how tight we've moved here over the past 5 weeks. You can see virtually nowhere. And this is, again, the small cap index, which is tends to be more volatile than the rest of the market, although you could argue that that's been the exact opposite for 2017. It's been very kind of choppy in here throughout the entire year. So keep an eye on this 139 all the way up to about 142 or so. I think that'll bring some interesting clues if we start to move outside of that. But for now, sideways, flat, 20 period, 8 period might, again, just be indicative of more of kind of a sideways chop for now into the second week of July. So that's the market environment overall. Bulls getting it in, putting in that stop, protecting the downside from that momentum, from that selling momentum happening. Now let's see if we can get some follow through. Let's see if we can get more sectors participating there on the upside. So let's move into some other major markets here. TLT had a tough week, second week in a row, got follow through lower. Take a look at this weekly chart of TLT. See, down 2% following through of last week's bearish engulfing bar, which snapped this rising trend line here. You can see we're back below the 20 period, closing below the 20 period EMA here on the weekly chart. So something to, a bit of concern here for that longer term TLT bulls. You can see the volume not really high, but certainly right up to the average volume there over the past 50 days weekly trading volume. And if you go back to that daily chart, you can see 122 right in here, right back to the prior resistance that we broke out from earlier in June or late May. So again, bulls really still haven't been able to stop the bleeding here. It continues to kind of roll over. Got a couple of gaps lower now that we have, or a couple of gaps above us now that the market has not yet filled. So still just nothing here, evidence to say that it's time to rush in and buy. And this trend remains lower. 8 and 20 period just crossed down here on the daily chart. So caution still advised there for TLT. If we go to the metals next, GLD continues to be in a world of pain here as well. Weekly chart, you can see 8 and 20 curling over, starting to lose support, this pivot low here from May. That's a bit of a concern. There's some more structure here from March, but this pattern here definitely isn't shaping up to be all that bullish. And if we continue to roll over, it can very quickly be back towards the lows or the start of the year prices for GLD. So not too interesting. Would need a sharp bounce back there for me to get interested. Silver, volume picking up here at towards the end of the week on Friday here, 19 million shares traded. You can see took out the lows from January. And if we go to that weekly chart, you can see this one really starting to break down here. We're making new lows on the year. So sellers firmly in control, 8 and 20 period, bearishly aligned, above price, heading lower. So caution again advised here. So sellers are in control of this trend on the weekly time frame. If we go to oil next, we'll go to the daily chart. You can see had a tough end to the week. If we go to the weekly chart, actually, 4% to the downside. That was following last week's 7.5% move to the upside. And again, you can see volume kind of upticking here the past few days. You can see a bit of a bounce off the lows. We talked about this in the midweek video as this kind of rallied up into or above some of these fast moving averages. If the sellers were to take control, which they seem to be trying to do, can we put in a higher low? Can we kind of trade back down to $9 or so, put in a higher low, and then start to muster up a bounce? That's what we talked about in the midweek video, talking about a potential trend change, or if we wanted to see some type of sideways action to start to form here, if we wanted to see a bottom, whether it be a short term or intermediate term bottom start to get put in, we'd want to see that higher low. We want to see some stabilization here. We don't want to just race all the way back to these lows here from mid-June. That would not be that constructive. So something to pay attention to here for you tactical traders. Of course, we're still in a longer term downtrend here. So from that price perspective on a trend basis on the longer time frame, still nothing to latch on to yet. But for you more tactical traders that are looking at maybe some of these momentum divergences or something in USO, time to pay attention to this as we come back down towards that $9 level. And natural gas, I thought we'd actually might get a trade in this today given the gap higher. I would have liked to see this gap hold and then some strength come in and follow through on the day, but the exact opposite happened. We actually just saw the gap get completely faded. The highs that we opened up the day here on Friday failed. We moved red and then closed near the lows. So still nothing all that interesting here. I still think the 650 level is an interesting level to pay attention to. It was the lows here for March, and we can see we're reacting a bit to it now, but so far no real bounce is materializing. You can see an uptick in volume, so something to pay attention to, but you know, not enough signs there at this point to jump in one way or the other. So natural gas is there, and I think that covers everything. Let's get into some of these other sectors here. So the big story, I guess, IYT, which is the transportation average here, weekly basis. You can see getting a nice weekly close, new highs here on 2017, very bullish sort of action after consolidating for quite a while. Since December, really, it's moved sideways below or around this 170 level, and we're finally starting to get back above it now. You can see up 1.27% here on Friday, so outperforming and leading nicely. That's the transportation average. You want to pay attention to those stocks. It's going to contain a lot of airlines, railroads, all those good names, those sturdy industrials. So IYT is the first. Financials continue to work higher, up 1.5%. Again, weekly close here at new highs for the year. If we go to the daily chart, you can see just holding up high and tight. Some, you know, good amount of volume, I guess, coming in here on the month of June as we've rallied up towards these prior highs here, 8 and 20 period. Fastly, rising, good momentum behind this move. So financials, I like them. We've talked about them for quite a while. XLV continues to kind of put in this nice pullback formation here. It was up on Friday, inside day from Thursday's sell-off, holding the 20 period. You get a nice clean sort of consolidation here. Pay attention to these names in this space because I do like them. It includes IBB, which again, I continue to like. I still hold the position here in IBB, which finished up almost 1% on the week. You can see volume really just kind of drying off here after this big breakout move since or towards the middle of June. And you can see we're just letting these moving averages catch up, 20 period just below price now. So it'll be interesting to see, you know, if this turns into be, you know, a nice kind of ABC pullback, or if we do roll over here, that of course wouldn't be desirable for my long position. We'd have to ultimately get stopped out of that if we started to move back down towards this breakout level. But for now, you can see buyers stepping in here, support trying to hold. Let's see if we can get some movement there in the biotechs into next week. And finally, let's go to the laggards. Some of the things that we've been talking about still stay weak. So staples, you can see just really had another tough week, down 1%. This is now 5 weeks down in a row into support. We would expect that there would be some reaction here, that there would be some type of bounce potential here as it's now sold off for 5 weeks in a row. Yet to be seen, but pay attention to 54.50. There, again, this is likely to be a spot where the market reacts to. Utilities, kind of the similar situation, just been selling off here the past couple of alternating weeks in here, but the past several weeks been to the downside, back into this consolidation area from March, April, and May. Something to pay attention there, attention to, and of course that is impacted by TLT and what rates are doing right now too. So it makes sense that you have utilities continuing to sell off. You got financials, which are catching the bid. Those aren't the only factors that influence those sectors, but they certainly do influence. So that's utilities, that's staples, technology. Again, kind of just similar to the Qs here. It's got to be a little bit suspect. It is holding support, but that bearishly aligned 8 and 20 period moving average, lower high situation, still something to let it prove itself to you. Not a sector I'd want to be aggressive on. At least that's just the way I look at these markets. XLY also, kind of fairly sloppy, still just channeling lower here, consolidating, but this is the discretionary ETF. You can see had a nice little bounce back here on Friday, up almost 1%, took out Thursday's highs, but still, just from a price structure perspective, it's a little messy as it continues to consolidate here. So something to keep an eye on, but kind of in the laggard group relative to some of those other sectors, those leaders that we talked about. And I think that's going to be where I'm going to end it. So thanks, guys, for watching. Enjoy your weekend and talk to you again soon.